Hey everyone, this is Carte and I'm back with an electrifying new tutorial that's bound to take your Maya and Arnold skills to the next level. Today we are exploring the realm of HDRI magic. I will guide you through the steps to seamlessly transform any studio light rig into a breathtaking HDRI environment. Prepare to see how Maya and Arnold work together to unfold this VFX wizard technique. No matter your experience level, this tutorial is filled with valuable insights to enhance your look dev skills. So get relaxed, grab a coffee or a cup of tea, and let's roll the intro! So guys, first off, for the purpose of illustrating this tutorial, I will be using this fantastic model created by Parasite Collectibles on mymanifactory.com. If you are not already familiar with this site, this is a must visit for downloading free 3D models. After downloading the 3D model, I took some time to prepare it properly for use in this tutorial. As you can see, the model is incredibly detailed and really impressive. It's a stunning, powerful creature, just the way we like it. Next, I've set up a basic studio look dev scene. You can see that we have an HDRI along with top, right and left lights. I've also added a rim light to add some flare. If we open the outliner, you will notice that everything is organized neatly. It's crucial to maintain good organization, especially if you are working in production with a team. So it's a good habit to develop early on. Let's launch the IPR to see what we've got. We have a very nice model and studio rig setup. To create an HDRI from our light studio setup, let's start by opening the outliner and switching to perspective mode. Then duplicate the main camera and position it at the center of the scene. Next, hide the creature geometry. We can also rename the camera to HDRI light rig for better organization. Then open the attribute editor and, under the camera shape tab, look for the Arnold option tab. Now change the camera type from perspective to spherical. This is a crucial step in creating our HDRI. Let's relaunch our IPR and switch to HDRI light rig camera. Boom, we are beginning to see something. Now select all the lights and set the camera visibility option to 1, as we want them to be visible in the HDRI, of course. Refresh the IPR and voila! Now we need to adjust the render size to match the HDRI lat-long ratio. So 4096 by 2048 for a 4K HDRI. Nice! Now just render it out. Once it's done, save it by clicking on File, then Save Multi-Layer EXR. A quick note here, your file will be in EXR format. You can easily convert it to HDR format in Photoshop, for example if you need to. Now, let's take a closer look at the power and usefulness of this technique. But first,
hey you, I know you're watching my video and I know you're not subscribed yet. It's literally so easy, just go down there and boom, press subscribe. So like this video, comment and hit the subscribe button.
Okay, now I'm in Substance Painter and you will see the true power of this technique. As you can see, I've already applied some surfacing to the model. It's a quick but quite nice texturing job on the creature with a touch of detail. I primarily used the Studio Tomaco environment map during the surfacing process. But now we can import our custom HDRI created from our original light scene. To do this, simply drag and drop the file. Select the environment type and click on Import. Then choose the newly imported HDRI for the environment map slot. Now just adjust the settings accordingly. And boom, voila! This is a really cool way to look dev your model with your final light rig directly in Substance Painter. Let's export all the textures and return to Maya to see the final result. Now, I will quickly create the shader tree for the model using my plugin Substance to Maya. With just one click, it's done. No pain or time loss in the creation process. Now, let's apply it to the model. Refresh the IPR. And boom! Wasn't this technique a super interesting, swift, and effective method to transform your lighting setup into an HDRI and ensure the accuracy of your surfacing in Substance Painter?
Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the content, you know what to subscribe to my channel for more awesomeness. And I see you guys in the next video.